तो आई थिंक ओके आई हैव स्टार्टेड द रिकॉर्डिंग, सो लेट मी शेयर माई स्क्रीन विद यू ऑल एंड दिस इज़ द स्क्रीन यू कैन सी। हाई एंड रासो, गुड इवनिंग। ओके सो 7 पीपल हैव जॉइंड, दैट इज़ ग्रेट। सो आर यू एबल टू सी माई स्क्रीन एवरीवन?
हाँ मैंने तो डाला था ये सब
ओके
चीज़ें।
ओके सो लेट
हाँ
एजेंडा
हाँ
फॉर
मेरी
टुडे।
स्टोरीज
ओके
में है,
सो व्हाट इज़ द
नहीं
एजेंडा फॉर
स्टोरीज में
टुडे यू
ऐसे
कैन
ही
सी
है।
ऑन माई स्क्रीन?
नहीं
वी विल
आपने उस
लर्न,
वाले में ना, आपने शेड्यूलर में, आपने शेड्यूलर कुछ डाला ही नहीं है वो बेस्ट वाली स्टोरी
वी
में,
विल लर्न
उसमें
हाउ टू
ऐसा कुछ
हैंडल,
लिखा नहीं है कि शेड्यूल्ड भी आना है।
हाउ
हालांकि
टू
आपने
हैंडल द
प्रेफरेंसेस का
कैलेंडर
स्क्रीन
यूआई,
डाला था, बट ईमेल जो है ना वो आपने सिंगल वाले डाला हुआ है।
द कैलेंडर यूआई। ओके सो ऑन द वेब पेज विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिलेनियम कोड। ओके सो टिल नाउ आई थिंक यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद बटन विद द टेक्स्ट बॉक्सेस काइंड ऑफ वेब एलिमेंट, बट हियर वी विल सी वन मोर वेब एलिमेंट। ओके विच इज़ कैलेंडर। सो सपोज इफ आई क्लिक ऑन दिस, दिस इज़ द वेबसाइट, लेट मी फर्स्ट ओपन इट अगेन। ओके आई हैव मिस्टेकनली क्लोज्ड माई क्रोम ब्राउजर, लेट मी ओपन इट अगेन। ओके रिकॉर्डिंग इज स्टार्टेड। सो व्हाट इज़ द वेबसाइट? पाथ टू यूएसए। ओके सो दिस इज़ द वेबसाइट .com-travel। सो दिस इज़ द वेबसाइट। सो इन दिस वेबसाइट लेट मी वेट फॉर दिस साइट टू ओपन। सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस डेट लेबल एंड इनसाइड दिस टेक्स्ट बॉक्स देर इज़ वन टेक्स्ट रिटन विच इज़ डेट ऑफ ट्रेवल। इफ आई क्लिक दिस, सो दिस इज़ वन कैलेंडर विल ओपन। ओके सो वॉट इज़ दिस? दिस इज़ ए कैलेंडर, यू कैन से कैलेंडर वेब एलिमेंट। ओके और यू कैन से द वॉट एवर इट इज़। सो दिस इज़ वन कैलेंडर बॉक्स विच विल ओपन। सो हियर फ्रॉम दिस कैलेंडर वी हैव टू सेलेक्ट वन डेट, एनी इट कैन बी ऑफ एनी ईयर। सो सपोज इफ आई हैव टू सेलेक्ट दिस डेट, सो वी कैन नॉट गो फॉरवर्ड आफ्टर सेप्टेम्बर 2022। सपोज इफ आई हैव टू सेलेक्ट दिस डेट। ओके सो हाउ, सपोज इफ आई क्लिक दिस, सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस डेट इज सेलेक्टेड। सो विद द
ये
हेल्प ऑफ
मैंने
सिलेनियम हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू, हाँ यू कैन से सेलेक्टेड दिस डेट। ओके सो दिस इज अवर
हाँ सर, इनिशियल
एजेंडा
वाले
फॉर
ईमेल
टुडे।
का तो करना पड़ता है सर,
सो
फिर
लेट
उसको
मी
अलग
फर्स्ट
से ईमेल
वॉट आई विल
वेरीफाई
डू,
अकाउंट होना चाहिए।
लेट मी अगेन ओपन वन मोर।
नहीं,
ओके सो इफ आई डू दिस,
आरडी वगैरह के लिए हम लोग नहीं कर
सपोज
सकते,
दिस इज माई
पर वगैरह
क्लास।
में करना तो करना पड़ेगा अगर दिखाना
ओके
है
सो
अकाउंट। तो अभी क्या करेंगे हम लोग, इमीडिएटली के लिए, क्योंकि
आई थिंक लेट मी
इनिशियल जो
क्रिएट
सर
वन
ने
मोर न्यू
बताया कि
क्लास।
सबका बाय डिफॉल्ट इमीडिएटली सिलेक्टेड हो, जैसा स्टोरी कह रही है कि आपका अगर कोई यूजर
सो
है तो उसके बाय डिफॉल्ट
इफ आई
इमीडिएटली
कम
सिलेक्टेड हो
हियर
जाएंगे,
एंड
अगर
देन,
बाकी यूजर चाहते हो प्रेफरेंसेस
सो
दे
इफ आई
सकते हो।
डिलीट दिस क्लास, ओके वी विल क्रिएट वन न्यू क्लास फ्रॉम स्क्रैच। आई विल डिलीट दिस। ओके आफ्टर दैट आई विल क्रिएट वन न्यू क्लास विच इज कैलेंडर
देखो
हाइफन
ये जो
डेमो।
आता है ना, ये जो
सो आई
डिस्प्ले
विल
नेम
चेक
होके
दिस
आता
एंड
है तो जो यूजर
अवर
नेम होगा
क्लास विल
वो
बी
भी आ
क्रिएटेड।
जाएगा, इसमें हम लोग को चेंज नहीं करना है ना,
सो वॉट आई
जो
विल
भी
डू,
डिस्प्ले नेम होगा।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू, एज यू नो दैट वी हैव टू सेट सम पाथ सो दैट अवर डॉट exe फाइल विल गेट
ये
एग्जीक्यूटेड।
तो
ओके
चेंज नहीं होगा डिस्प्ले नेम, अब मैं तो डिस्प्ले नेम फील्ड होता है।
सो दिस इज नॉट द वन डॉट, दिस इज द
हाँ
वन। ओके
अगर
सो
ये,
हियर वॉट इज द वेब ड्राइवर?
हाँ
डॉट क्रोम डॉट ड्राइवर इज द की एंड वॉट इज द वैल्यू? आई थिंक आई हैव ऑलरेडी हैव इट इन माई मशीन। सो आई थिंक लेट मी ओपन दिस और आई थिंक आई विल गो टू हियर फाइल एक्सप्लोरर।
ऊपर करना हो तो देखना। अच्छा
सो आई थिंक इन साइड डाउनलोड्स आई विल गेट दिस।
लोकेश, आपने जब ये
ओके आई थिंक दिस इज द
मैसेंजर
वन यू
लोकेश
कैन
आपने
से।
देखा था क्या ये, आपने जो यहाँ पर ये वैल्यू दिखाई है, ये
ओके आई
डिस्प्ले
थिंक आई
नेम का
नीड
है या
टू
फिर
एक्सट्रैक्ट
फर्स्ट
इट।
नेम लास्ट नेम ऑफेंडर के लिए?
सो लेट मी, दिस इज यू कैन से दिस इज ए फाइल, आई विल सिंपली
हाँ
क्लिक इट एंड देन आई विल
हाँ
एक्सट्रैक्ट ऑल।
मैंने भी
सो
डिस्प्ले
दिस
नेम
इज
किया
द,
है,
ओके रिप्ले, आई एम रिप्लेसिंग द फाइल, इट इज
रजिस्टर
ऑलरेडी
नेम
प्रेजेंट
वाला।
बिकॉज। सो दिस इज द पाथ वेयर दिस exe फाइल इज प्रेजेंट। आई विल कॉपी दिस पाथ एंड वॉट विल हैपन, वॉट आई विल राइट द पाथ हियर एंड आई विल राइट माई फाइल नेम एज वेल विच इज़ क्रोम ड्राइवर। okay, this is mandatory to do after you paste the path. After that, what will happen? Let me put semicolon at the end. Okay, so I will simply create one object of Chrome driver class. So here I am just saying that object is of type web driver class, so which is driver equals to Chrome driver. Okay, after that what I will do, I will simply open one website. So what is the website here? You can see. Okay, so what is the website? If I come here, I think this is the one, right? So I will copy the link of this website, close this, and then I will paste the website here. Okay, so this is what will happen. Let me first import the package. So this is the package and this is also one package. Okay, error will be gone. After that I will open one website, so this will open me the website. After opening the website, so if I come here and let me close this, what is the website name? This is the website. So our first step should be to open the calendar. Okay, so if I click this anywhere in this date of travel box, I will click this, so it will open. So our first step should be to click this calendar. Okay, you can say the box. So what, how I will click that? Right click, inspect. Okay, again the same step, just click inspect this and click this. So you can see that this is the coding part they have done for this text box. You can see the highlighted text box on the top. I will use this name attribute to write my XPath. Okay, you can write CSS as well, but here I am using XPath. So I will, what, how I will write my XPath? Let me open this. So what is the syntax of the XPath? Tag name, @ attribute, I am writing in short, value. Okay, so if I try to write the XPath for this, so input is my tag name here. So I will write \ input is my tag name, and then name is our attribute. So I will write @ name equals to, what is the name value? This is our attribute value, travel hyphen date. So you can see our XPath will become like this. So this is our XPath. Okay, so I will first copy this XPath. I will check whether we are getting only one element with the help of this XPath or not. So if I try to open my CrowPath, if I paste it here, maybe I will get more than one element. Okay, so if I paste this XPath, you will see that it is highlighting only this element, so which means our XPath is correct, and only we are getting one element. So we can come, we are able to say that our XPath is correct. Okay, so I will write one method after landing on the site. I will write one more method, which is find element, and how to find the element with the help of XPath. So I am writing by.xpath, and what is the XPath we have formed? This is the XPath we have formed, and after that, after locating the element, we have to click on it. So I will use this method. So this will open the calendar. So this is fine till here, then I will move forward. Please confirm. Okay, so this is our website. Okay, so you can see after I will click this website, okay, I will click this website. So by default you can see that this, even if I refresh this website, you can see, even if I refresh this, what will happen if I click this? Okay, for the first time if I click this, okay, it has gone. Okay, if I click this, so you can see that it is opening. Okay, again I have to click it. You can see that it is opening the current month, which is September, and also it is highlighting the current date. Okay, which is fine, but our task is to not to select from this. What if you have to select any date from here? You can say May 2021. Then our first task should be to navigate to this particular, whatever this is, May 2021. Suppose if I have to navigate to, you can say October 2021, then with the help of this next button, I will first move till here, October 2021. Then from this month, I will try to select any particular date, okay, which is from 1 to 30, okay, for this month, then I will select. Okay, so what I'm saying again, when the calendar will open, it will by default start from September month, because September is our current month, and हाँ, यू कैन से दैट डेट इज 17.
उनकी तबीयत खराबी बारे में
सो
बात
व्हाट आई एम
करनी
सेइंग
थी,
विद द हेल्प ऑफ
तो
दिस
उन्होंने
नेक्स्ट
कुछ उस
बटन
इशू
आई
को
विल
कॉल कर लिया।
कीप ऑन क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस बटन अंटिल आई विल रीच माई
हाँ, मैं
डिजायर्ड
थोड़ा
मंथ
आगे
एंड द
बढ़ता
ईयर.
हूँ।
ओके, सो व्हाट आई विल डू, फर्स्ट व्हाट आई टू क्लिक ऑन दिस बटन, फर्स्ट आई विल डील विद दिस. ओके, व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल एक्सट्रैक्ट द टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस, वट एवर द टेक्स्ट. सपोज दिस इज दैट अप्रैल 2022 इज द टेक्स्ट, देन आई विल ट्राई टू
हाँ
फैच इट. इफ
हाँ
दिस इज द टेक्स्ट,
हाँ
देन
हाँ
आई विल ट्राई टू फैच इट. ओके, सो आई विल टेल यू दैट वाई वी आर फैचिंग दिस टेक्स्ट. ओके, यू विल गेट एज सुन एज द कोड विल, आई विल राइट द कोड, यू विल गेट इट. ओके, डोंट वरी.
शायद मेरे को
सो वॉट आई
थोड़ा
विल
सा
डू,
वो
आई हैव टू
पूरा
फर्स्ट
वो
गेट
है
द टेक्स्ट, वॉट एवर द टेक्स्ट इज प्रेजेंट हियर.
आईडी को
आई विल
बताया।
क्लिक दिस एंड आई विल कम हियर एंड देन क्लिक इट. क्लिक इट एंड आफ्टर दैट यू विल सी, सो इट हैज़ नॉट ओपन्ड इट प्रॉपरली. अगेन क्लिक इट. ओके, सो आई थिंक दिस इज नॉट द वन. ओके, लेट मी ओपन इट अगेन. ओके, सो इट हैज़ ओपन्ड इट. यू कैन सी इफ आई हाईलाइट दिस, सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज द कोडिंग पार्ट. यू कैन सी मे 2022 इज रिटन हियर. सो आई विल राइट फर्स्ट आई ईदर एक्सपाथ और सी एस एस, इट्स अप टू यू, राइट, विच यू हैव टू राइट. यू कैन राइट एक्सपाथ फॉर दिस एज वेल, सी एस एस एज वेल यू कैन राइट. ओके, और यू कैन यूज दिस क्लास नेम एज वेल, लोकेटर. बट हियर आई एम गोइंग विद एक्सपाथ, सो हाउ आई विल राइट द एक्सपाथ, यू कैन सी ऑन द ग्रो पाथ. ओके, आई विल रिमूव दिस. सो वॉट इज द सिंटेक्स, डबल स्लैश, यू कैन सी द टैग नेम इज टी एच, टैग नेम इन साइड दिस एरे ब्रैकेट आई विल राइट एट द रेट. वॉट इज द एट्रीब्यूट, क्लास इज द एट्रीब्यूट, आई विल कॉपी दिस, आई विल पुट क्लास हियर. ओके, आफ्टर दैट वॉट इज द एट्रीब्यूट वैल्यू, दिस इज द वैल्यू.
सामने चला के दिया था ना सुनील
ओके
को वो पूरा,
ओके, सो
मतलब
दिस इज
सारे
द
टाइप ऑफ इमेज देने, सारे टाइप ऑफ
वैल्यू, डेट पिकर हाइफन
रेफरेंस
स्विच,
डिफरेंट टाइप
लेट मी
का
कॉपी दिस,
सब।
कॉपी डिट एंड देन आफ्टर दैट वॉट आई विल राइट. ओके, सो यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज द एक्सपाथ, दिस इफ आई कॉपी दिस, दिस इज द एक्सपाथ फॉर दिस. ओके, इफ आई प्रेस एंटर, सो हियर यू आर गेटिंग मोर देन वन एलिमेंट फॉर द सेम एक्सपाथ, राइट. सो इफ आई सी ट्राई टू सी दिस, वॉट आर दोज थ्री एलिमेंट, लेट मी ओपन दिस. सो फर्स्ट इज दिस वन. ओके, सो इट इज नॉट शोइंग अस. आई
वो देखना सुविधा टीम इस तरह मैं
थिंक
भेजा हुआ फिर
लेट मी ओपन
उसमें लिखा
ओपन
था ना टाइम नेक्स्ट टाइम टाइम
इफ आई ट्राई टू सर्च इट अगेन.
या तो वो तो गूगल पर कन्वर्ट कर देगी।
ओके, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज दिस.
नहीं आर्ली भी
ओके,
था
लेट
ना
मी ओपन माय क्रोपाथ
उसमें,
अगेन.
आर्ली भी था ना उसमें, सारे ही इंटरवल के बेस।
सो वी आर गेटिंग थ्री एलिमेंट.
हाँ
इफ आई ओपन माय क्रोपाथ अगेन एंड देन इफ आई ट्राई टू, सो एज ऑफ नाउ इट इज नॉट हाईलाइटिंग, बट इफ एज सुन एज आई क्लिक इट, इट विल, इट इज शोइंग वी थ्री एलिमेंट. ओके, इफ आई प्रेस एंटर नाउ, सो फर्स्ट इज दिस वन. सो इफ आई ट्राई टू सर्च, दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन. आई थिंक इट इज
ये
शोविंग
उसने
द
क्वेरी
एक्सपाथ फॉर द
डिपार्टमेंट ये
सेम.
नहीं देखा, उसने अपने
ओके, सो यू
अकॉर्डिंग
कैन
देखा
सी
कि अगर
वॉट
सबका
इज द
सेम
वाई
है।
वी आर गेटिंग मोर देन टू, लेट मी चेक इट.
मैं रन करके भेजता
सो यू
हूँ।
कैन सी इट इज नॉट हाईलाइटिंग, बट यू कैन सी दैट दे हैव यूज द सेम क्लास, डेट पिकर हाइफन स्विच फॉर दिस एलिमेंट. एंड इफ आई प्रेस एंटर अगेन, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन, इट इज हाईलाइटिंग. ओके, यू कैन से मे 2022. ओके, मे 2022 रिटन हियर, दैट मीन्स आवर फर्स्ट
हाँ
एक्सपाथ इज
सब
फॉर
कुछ
दिस
सही
एलिमेंट.
है,
इफ आई
सब
प्रेस
कुछ
एंटर
सही
अगेन,
है।
इफ आई प्रेस एंटर अगेन हियर, इफ आई प्रेस एंटर, देन यू विल सी दैट फॉर दिस 2022 ओनली दिस वन, देयर इज वन मोर एक्सपाथ विच इज दिस वन. ओके, सो हियर यू
राइट
कैन
राइट
सी
तो
दैट
सेम
टैग
लास्ट
नेम
टाइम
इज
था।
सेम, क्लास इज ऑल्सो सेम एंड द क्लास वैल्यू इज ऑल्सो सेम, डेट पिकर हाइफन स्विच. दिस इज द रीजन दैट वी आर गेटिंग मोर देन थ्री एलिमेंट इन अवर एक्सपाथ. सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट इन दैट केस यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस एक्सपाथ. ओके, जस्ट स्पेस, जस्ट राइट विच एलिमेंट यू आर लुकिंग फॉर.
नेक्स्ट
आई एम
रन टाइम
लुकिंग
जो है
फॉर
ना
माई फर्स्ट एलिमेंट.
वो है अब
आई विल प्रेस
15
एंटर, दिस टाइम यू विल सी
और
दैट
उसका
इट
टाइम
इज
जो है
जस्ट
10 है।
हाईलाइटिंग ओनली दिस, वॉट आई विल से ओनली दिस मे 2022, राइट. इवन इफ आई
हाँ
सपोज इफ आई कम हियर, September to 2022. So in that case as well, if you use that XPath, this is the XPath, okay?
So
if you use that XPath, it will highlight that, and with that, we have already written the XPath for the same. So with the help of getText method, we can easily retrieve the values as well, okay? So this way, this is one way. This is the way we can go step by step. So what I will write, one more method, which is again find element by dot XPath. By dot XPath. What is the XPath? This is the XPath, and what I will write, get text. So till now, is it clear to everyone that how I am fetching the month and the year? Okay, whatever the month and the year. Okay, so after that I will going to use one more method, which is contains. Why we are using that I will tell you shortly. Okay, here I am checking whether, suppose if I am interested in this one, okay, let me, if I am interested in February 2022, right? So what I will write, inside contains February 2022. I think this is the one we are written it correctly. Okay, so what I'm saying, after you get the text, suppose we are here, okay? Suppose I'm starting from starting. So if I'm starting from the beginning, okay? As soon as we click on this box, it will open by default. It will highlight 17th date by default, okay? Because 17 is our present date. As soon as I am here, so first of all, it will get with the text. So September 2020 will be fetched by this line. September 2020, right? This line will give us what? September 2020. Then it will check whether it is equal to this one. Contains method will help us to check whether September 2020 is equals to February 2022. So you can say, but we have to, so this time the condition will become false, okay? So what I will do, because I have to keep on checking, I will click this. Again, I will fetch this text and I will try to match the text with this. So we have to keep on executing the condition till I will find this one, okay? Okay, so let us put that in a while loop. So it will going to execute again and again. See here how it will. I will put that in a while loop. Okay, after that I will put the two braces of while loop. Okay, so what will happen first time? Okay, again let me come here. What I'm saying, by default it will open from here, okay? By default. So first time when you try to get the text September 2020, so this line will give you what? September 2020 for the first time. After that it will check whether it is that this text will contain this. So you can see that condition will become false, okay? And we will not go inside the value because condition will become false. But our intention is to, what we have to do, if the condition will not match, what I am saying, if I come here, I am saying that September 2020 is not equal to this one, okay? Is not equal to this one. What I have to do, I have to first click on this next button and then I will check again, okay? Then I will proceed further again and again. So our intention is to, you can say, but you can see that condition will become false. This condition will become false first time, because it is not equal to this. So what I will do, I will put one not operator here. You can see here, this is the one not operator. What will happen when this condition will become false for the first time? We have put one not operator here. So let me write it in comment. Not of false equals to true. Okay. So what will happen? Not of false will become true. So we will come inside the while loop. Come inside while loop. So is it clear to everyone that how we are coming inside the while loop? Okay. Fine. So after when we come inside the while loop, what we have to do? We have to click on this button, this next button, so that we will again check for that next month and the year. Okay. So I will inside the while loop, I will write one code to click on this every time. So how I will write? Let me first close this. Let me come to my original Chrome browser. So this is the one. So what I have to do, I have to click on this. Okay, so come here and then click here. So this is the one. Let me. Okay, so this is the one. You can say that it is highlighting this next button, or you can say the next arrow, whatever it is. So this is our tag name, th. I will make use of this one class again. Okay, tag name attribute is our class, and value of the class is next. So I will write the xpath again for this. What is the xpath? Would be double slash tag name. You can see on the right hand side. Okay, of micro path tag name, and then at the rate. What is the attribute? Class is the attribute equals to. What is the value? Next is the value. I will hit enter again. You are getting more than one element, so you do not have to worry. Just put in braces. Suppose if I put one. So I think you will get this element only. Okay, so even if I, you can see that if I have put it one, I am getting only this xpath of first element, which is this one. So this is the xpath for that next button. And what I will do inside this while loop, I will write driver dot find element by dot xpath. What is our xpath? This is the one. Okay, and I will write click. Okay, so that we will be able to click on next button. So if I try to execute this code now, you will see. Let us check whether it is working correctly or not first. Okay, so let us execute this code first again. You will see that we will redirect it to here again. Okay, let us check February 2022 is highlighting or not. So let us wait for the website to open. So it has opened, and okay, I think I have to put some wait here because this pop-up is coming for a few seconds. Maybe our script will fail. Let us see. So we have come here. After that, you will see that it will click on a calendar, and it will keep on clicking to this until you will reach February 2022. So you can say this. Okay, so this way you can first reach here. You can say February 2022. First, you will reach here. After reaching here, we have to select any date from this you can say calendar. So, is it clear to everyone, or should I try to debug this? How it is working? Please confirm. Which one? Sorry. You can use for loop as well, but I think it is better to go with the while loop here because we do not know. See what I am saying. Maybe till here you can see that. Let me come here first from starting, right? So suppose we are starting from here. Okay, I have to reach February 2022. So 1 time, 2 time, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16. So I think for 17 times we have to click, right? So we can use for loop. That is fine, right? But what happens? Suppose you will have February 2099, something like this. So is it to be good way to keep on counting how many times you have to click to reach here, right? It is not a good way. So, but in case of while loop, you do not have to worry about that. So this is the reason why I'm saying that while loop is more feasible here, right? You can use for loop as well. That is fine. So keep on using while loop. So you do not have to worry how many times you have to execute the loop. While loop will do that for you. Okay. So any more issues in this code? So let me explain this. So what will happen? Suppose you came here, okay, February 2022, and here also you are saying that it should match it. Okay, so what will happen? This line will fetch the text which is February 2022 because we came here. So this will be fetched, and this is the method. It is checking whether it is equal to this one. So condition will become true this time. You can say that till now condition will become true, but we have put one not condition. So not of true, I will write not of true will become false. So this time this inner part will not execute because condition has become false and we will come out of this while loop. So this is how it is working. So we can try with one more, you can say, suppose if I have to June 2022, suppose if I have to come here, so just write June here. Okay, this time you will see that you will be able to navigate to this. Okay, this code will work fine this time as well, June 2022. So let us check. Then we will try to select how to hide, how to select the date in the calendar. So you can see that it is again opening one pop-up. Okay, so you can say that our code is failed due to this pop-up. Okay, code is failed due to because this pop-up. So what I will do, I will just simply paste one after that, I think. After that, I am writing just thread.sleep. Okay, so our script will pause for how many milliseconds? 9000 milliseconds, okay. So add thrust declaration also as well. So 9000 millisecond, after that it will execute. So this time it will not fail because we have put some weight. So it will, okay, come here. So this time we have given June 2022, so let us check whether we are able to come till here or not. So you can see the site is taking more time to load.
Okay,
so you can see here it has opened the calendar and it will keep on clicking till you can say June 2022. So you can see that this way we are able to come till this part, and after that our duty is to select any date from here. Okay, so is it clear to everyone? Okay, so okay, what is this pop-up coming again and again? Okay, let us, so our next agenda should be to, we have done the, till this part, and now we have to select one date. So as of now you can see that I am hard coding the data. Okay, I am hard coding the data, but after this you can say, after I will write the full code, I will ask the user every time, okay, to tell which year and the which month date he has to select. Okay, so as of now understand this only. Okay, I have hard coding the data here, and suppose if I have to select one date, so how I will do, suppose if I am coming here, so you can say that there are some dates here as well. You can say 30 31. I think you are able to see that these are less highlighted and these are, you can say, dark one. You can say from 1 to 28, right? You can see again that 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 up to 12 are less highlighted, right? So you can say that February has 28 days only, right? So these dates are coming from the, you can say, if I come here, these dates are of another month, right? But we are not interested on these dates. We are interested from 1 to 28, right? Because February has 28 days from 1 to 28. If I come from to this March month, right? You can see again from 1 to 31. From 1 to 31, we are only interested in these dates. We are not interested in these dates, right? So are you able to see? Again, if I come to April, so April will start again from first date, and after that till 30. We are not interested in these dates, right? Less highlighted one. So we are, again, if I come to this, so you can see these are the less highlighted, and you can see from 1 to 31. So what I will do, I will write one XPath for all these dates. I will write one XPath. So again, the same method, I will first click this. Suppose if I am selecting this, so you can see the, this is the, you can say, coding part they have done. So we can easily write XPath. What can be the XPath? TD class equals to day. TD at the rate class day. So if I click this, you will see it will highlight all the dates. So you can see we have total of 31 dates here. Okay, so this is, you can say that it is this XPath alone is able to select all the element. Okay, so likewise, if I copy this XPath and if I come here, if I come to any of the months, so suppose this is the month, if I paste the same XPath here and press enter, so you can say that whatever the dates, see, it is just saying till 17, right? Even if I come here, July month, okay, if I press enter, again, you will see that it is highlighting only the dates that is present in this month from 1 to 31, right? Even if I come to any random month, February 2022, so you can see that it is able to highlight 1 to 28 element. So with the help of this XPath, we will first fetch all the date. How we will going to fetch, see here. So I will write one simple method, driver.find. So this time we are dealing with more than one date. I will go with this method, find element. So please confirm, this method is already discussed, I think, right? Find elements, please confirm us. Okay, so what I will do, I will use this method only. Okay, so driver.find elements, how I have to find the element? With the help of XPath. So by.XPath is the one I will provide, and after that, this is the one. Okay, so it will get me all the dates present on the particular month. As it is returning me the date, I will capture that in a list of web element. So element. Okay, so what is the, you can say, suppose the variable is of type, suppose the variable image dates. After that, so I will first import one package, I think this is the one, and import the package from here as well. Yeah, this is the one, that's all. Okay, so what will happen after this statement will execute, it will have all the 31 dates from 1 to 31, right? From 1 to 30, because we have written XPath for this. Even if you are here, then it will just fetch all the dates from 1 to 31. So this, you can say, this variable which is type list will have all the 31 dates. Okay, after that, what I will do, I will just find the size of my list. So int size dates dos size. Okay, so do not confuse with this one, and this is our variable name. You can give it any variable, right? So this is the method, so that it will give me how many dates are present in this list. Okay, so this method will give me the exact size. After that, what I will do, I will run one for loop for I equals to 0. I will tell you why I am writing 0 here, not 1. I equals to 0, I less than, you can say, size, and plus plus I. Okay, so okay, we are getting one error. Let me put integer here. Fine. After that, what will happen? Let me wait. Okay, we are recording. Yes, so what I will say after that, what I will do, I will say driver dot, let me first okay, not driver dot, it is, see, I'm just executing the for loop, and so this is the variable that is having all the dates, okay? But that dates is not in the form of text. It is just a kind of web element, right? So dates, this will have all the dates as web element. So I am copying this variable. Here, what I will write, dates dot get of, I will write I here. I am say, let me explain you as well. Let me write it first. I will write get of text. So after that, I will capture the date in one string variable, because getText will return me the string variable. Okay, so see here, what this line is doing. Let me tell you first this way. So I am saying this variable will have all the dates. Okay, suppose this variable, let me remove this. What I am saying, suppose this dates variable, all the dates in form of went. Okay, so suppose the dates are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to suppose 30. Okay, this time. So what I am saying, and as this is a list, let me write one here, as this is a list, index will start from 0. So this is the reason I am starting my for loop from 0. Okay, so if I come here again, okay, let me, okay, so what I was saying, so this date 1 is present at 0 index. So this date number 2 will present at 1 index, and it will present at second index. Okay, so likewise you can see that index value keep on increasing for any particular date. So what I was saying, this statement dates dot get of i, let me first copy this, so let me paste it here only. So what I'm saying that this dates will have all these value, you can say the dates. Okay, so I'm saying get me the, suppose if I write 0 here, so what I'm saying, get me the date present at 0 index. So I will get this date if I write index value 2 here. Okay, so this is the 2. So what I'm saying, get me this date which is 3 present at index 2. But you can say that this step is alone not sufficient to get this date. Okay, you have to write one more method which is get text. So you will get the text of the date as well. So text is, you can say this is in the text format, this is in the text format. So this is the reason I am writing this method here. And you can say that if I write one more, if I try to print the date, so let us check whether it is printing the date or not. Okay, first of all let us check. So this is not our agenda to print the date, all the dates, but we are just checking whether we are able to fetch all the dates or not. Okay, so let us see it again. So again it will keep on going till I think February 2022. Okay, not February this time, I think we have given June. So after we are come to this June 2022, then you can see that it has printed all the dates, you can see on the console from 1 to you can see 30, right? So it is, so this step is clear because we are able to fetch all the dates and we are able to print that as well. But our agenda was not to okay, let us first show this, try to see this in debugging mode also, then it will be more clear that how it is fetching the date and how it is storing the date. So let me show you in debug mode this time. So let us wait for the website to open. So it is again open. So what will happen, you will see again it will open the calendar UI. Okay, so I don't know why. Okay, so it has clicked the calendar, you can see. It will again come to June 2022, then our script will pause because we have put one debugger. Okay, so you can see the script is paused. Okay, see here what I'm saying, driver dot find elements by dot xpath. Okay, I have already shown you the xpath in my CrowPath, so and you have seen there as well, we are able to highlight all the dates present on the calendar for the particular month and year. If I execute this statement, highlighted one, okay, what will happen, see that will contain all the dates. If I try to see this, you can see, let me try to expand it, I think this way. Okay, so what I'm saying, you can see here that at 0th index some kind of web element is present. Okay, so let me tell you that web element is your date. So at 0 index one date is present, at 1 index one date is present in the form of web element. Likewise you can see if I come here, you will see, you can say that it has fetched all the dates, but you are not seeing the text here, okay, because the dates is in the form of web element. Okay, so what I will do, I will first calculate the size, that how many dates that date variable which is of type list will have. Okay, so if I execute this, you will see the size. So size is 30, you can see. Okay, so we have total 30 dates. Okay, but remember that thing, that text of the date is not present here, right? They are in the form of WHERE element. If we have to get the text, then we have to use the method getText. Okay, so I am just executing one for loop here that will start from I. And if I come here, so what is happening here, you can see, let me also remove this. Okay, so you will be able to see that it is printing as well. So what I'm saying, you can say I value equals to zero here. So what I'm saying, dates will have all these dates variable will have all the dates in the form of WHERE element, right? So as I value is zero, we will come to this first one, I value equals to zero. And after that, I'm saying get me the text present on this WHERE element, which is one. Okay, so which is one. If I try to execute this, so I think it is not going inside. Let me put one debugger here. If I try to execute it again, so I think I need to execute it again because I will not be able to show you if, let me check this time. Okay, I think it has come, you are right. Okay. No, that is fine, I am saying that text. Okay, so data text is not present here. So you can see that, yeah, I value is changing, which means it is executing, but somehow I don't know. I faced this issue again, so let me run it again, okay. So I remove debugger from here. Let me put debugger here, okay. So this time you will see. Let me open, run it again, and let me close this as well. Okay, so let us check again. I think we are not seeing that because I have made some changes in the code at runtime. So I think due to this reason, we are not able to see. But let us see this time, it will be fine. So again, the site is loading. So it has again clicked on it. After that, it will click on till June 2022, right? And after that, our script will pause. So I think we are here. You can see. So first time, I'm saying that will have all the dates in the form of WHERE element. At zero index, there is one WHERE element, okay, which is a date. You are not seeing the text here because if you want to see the text of the WHERE element, you have to use one method, which is get text. So here, likewise, you can see that so many dates are here, right? So many dates are here. What I'm saying, get me the date which is presented I equals to zero. I value is zero here. Okay. So what it will do? It will first go to this. So this is the first one. If I say zero index. Okay. So get me the WHERE element of zero, and get me the text as well. So what is the text you will get? You will get one. You can see one here. Okay. So this is how it has fetched one date from that. After that, it will print it. Again, I value will become one. So if I execute it again, you will see I value equals to 1. So what is this? This will have all the WHERE element dates. Okay. So this is the index 1. It has one date. Okay. If you want to get the text, what is the text of this WHERE element? You have to use this method, which is get text. Again, if I execute this, you will see 2 will come here. So you can say the date is 2. Likewise, again, if I try to execute it one more time, you will see. If I put I value equals to 3, sorry, 2 this time. So it will have all the dates in the form of WHERE element. We will see that this is the second index. Okay. I am saying get me the text. So I am saying get the text of that WHERE element, which is present at index 2. Again, it will give me the one more, you can say date, which is 3. You can say 3 will become here. Okay. So we are just printing it. So this is how it is working internally. I have shown you with the help of debugging. So is it clear to everyone? You can see after that it will print all the dates one by one. Okay. So sorry. Okay, so I think everyone is clear with that. Okay, so as of now, our task was not to print the date. Our task was to click the date. Okay, so to click the date, what I will do? Use click method. Okay, as usual, I will put one if condition first. If so, this is the actual date I am getting. Okay, after using the get text method, I am getting the date here. If I will write if date dot contains. Okay, so I have to check. Suppose this is the date. Suppose date will have 23 here. Suppose date equals to 23 this time. Suppose I am saying okay. So suppose date equals to 23 in this. If date equals to 23, what we have to do? We have to get that. You can say again. I am writing dates dot. Will explain you. Don't worry. Again, I will write dates dot get of I. This time I will click the date. What I am saying, if suppose I will start from 1. Again, I will start from 1. Okay. If I will come write 1 here. So I hope you are all have clear with that when the index value has 0, when I will become 0, that will have some kind of, you can say, web element, right, in the form of date. So what will happen? When we will try to fetch the date for the first time, 1 will come here, and I am saying 1 will contain 1, which is true. What will happen? We will go inside this for if condition, and I am saying that inside that dates variable, which will have all the web element, okay, in the form of date, get me the first element, or you can say the zero index element, okay, web element, and then just click on it. Okay, this will click on the date. Simple. Okay, so again, if I write suppose 25 year, so let me write 5 year. So one thing you should notice, that suppose this is the date. Suppose if I have to click on this, okay, after reaching December 2021, I have to click on this 15 date, which is fine. But you will see, after I will click on this date, I do not want to traverse my for loop. You can say that suppose total, suppose 30 dates are here, right? So total our for loop will run 30 times, because it will have 30 dates. You can see, let me open this, because I am running my for loop till the size. Suppose the size is 30, but suppose if you found out the date at index, suppose this one, after that you do not want to traverse your for loop. So what I will do, as soon as I click one date, okay, I will just put one statement, which is break statement. Which means I will not execute my for loop further. Okay, which is straightforward, because we do not want to keep on looping even we have find our desired, you can say, element. Okay, so is it clear to you all that why I am putting this break statement? And one more thing, that even if you do not put a break statement, I will show you that it will throw an error. Okay, let us not deal with the error as of now. Let us check whether we are able to select this date 5. Okay, this date is 5, and if you see here, what is the month? June 2022. So this is the month, this is the, you can say, month and the year, and this is the date we are interested to click on. So what will be the date will become? So if I come here, so this is the date, June 2022, and 5 is the date. So we should get our output like this in our box, you can say. So let us copy this. So I will get my output like this when I try to run this program. So let us first click close all these browser. Okay, so close this as well, and I will run my, okay, I have saved my program, and then I will run it. So let us check whether it is able to selecting 5 June 2022 or not. So it has opened the browser. we will see it will again started to come till June 2022. After that, you can see that it has clicked on this one. This is the reason we are seeing 5 year, right? So even if you open this, so you can see that this date and this date is the same. So is it clear to everyone that how it is clicking any particular date? We can try one some more combinations as well. Suppose if I try to write 16 year, right? This time 16 year, and instead of June here, suppose if I write April, okay. So I have to select April 2022. And what is the date I have to select? 16. So 16 April 2022. So where is this April? Let us first check what is the output we should. So we should get our date like this time, okay. I will copy this, and this time I should get our date like this, 16 April 2022. So let us try to run this program again. Okay, so I will run it again. So again, it will click on the box so that our calendar will open. So let us wait for the website to load again. So site has finished loading completely, and then I think it will click on the calendar. So it will click it, and after that it will go to till I think April 2022. After that it will click on 16. So you can see that, okay, this is the one. Our program is executed successfully and it is able to click this, right? So is it clear to everyone that how it is selecting any particular date? So you can see that this is the same date if I open the last browser. Okay, so what I was saying, you can see that this is the same date which this code is selected, right? Every time you can see that, right? These two dates are the same. For April 16 is the date and 4 April is the month. Okay, so what I was saying, if I do not put a break statement here, whether I will be getting any error, let us check. Maybe I am not sure, but I think I am 99% sure that it will throw an error, okay, which is like array index out of bound. Let us check whether it is throwing some error like this after clicking on the date. Maybe it will not throw, I am not sure. Okay, I think this time it will not throw the error. Okay, it will not throw the error even if you do not put in the break statement. It will work fine. Again, it will select. So it has come to again April 2022, you can see on the screen, and it will click the date 16. Okay, so you can see our code is failed. So you can see, okay, so any issues here? Any, you can say, what is the issue here? Can anyone guess why we are getting this error? We are getting something like this still element, right? Means that element has become something like that, element has become old, something like this. Element is not attached to the page document. Why? Any guesses? Anyone? You can see that it is very well. Sorry. Okay. Yeah, you are correct. So what is happening here? When you are trying to click on this 16 date, right? You click on 16, then that you can say calendar will disappear, right? It is not in open mode. So this is the reason that you will not be able to fetch this date, and you will, okay, because we are just what we are doing. Suppose this 16th date is on the, suppose 15th index, okay? So after 15th index, what will happen? if you click on that 15th index, that calendar will disappear. So again, what you will do, you are trying to get, suppose at 16th index, suppose at after you click this, calendar disappear, but with the help of for loop, you are trying to fetch that next element as well, right? So it is just saying, because this has disappeared, so this is the reason if we are not putting the break statement here, we are getting issues. So you can see how important it is to put the break statement here, otherwise you will going to get one error. So is it clear to everyone? So you should put, okay, so one more point I will try to do. This time, till the time I was just hard coding the value, right? But this time I will not hard code the value. I will just ask from the user every time before my program start that what is the value you want to, what is the date you want to select, right? So let me import the package. Let me write double n here. Okay. So suppose if I write system.out.println, enter the date. So what I will write is string. Yes. Okay, so one more point here is that maybe you will try to write the string in the form of integer. Int str equals to, suppose what I will write, sc.nextint is the method to enter any input value. You can say the integer value from the user. But here you, what you will see, when we are getting the text, you can say we are getting the date here, but get text method will return the string in the form of you can say a string, right? Get text method will return you the date in the form of a string. So here also, if you want to compare the date here, it should be in the string format only. Okay. So here just I will make this variable as a string format, and I will write next line is the method. If you want to enter any string value by the user, you can use that method, and that date will come here. Okay. So I will write date here. Okay. And I will put semicolon after that. Okay, after that what I will do, we have entered the date. I will also say enter the month, enter the month, and you can say year. Okay, so again I will declare one string variable. So you can say month here, something like this. Okay, month here is what I will write, sc dot next. You can say this is the method. Okay, so here that variable will contain the month and the year. Okay, so what I will do, instead of writing hard coding the value here, I will just provide the variable here. Okay, so I will provide the value here. Okay, so whatever the value user will write, it will work accordingly, right? Again also, this is the date. I will copy the variable, and here the one we have provided the date, right? So I will provide that variable here. So every time whatever the user will provide the value, that program will work accordingly, right? So if I try to execute this, yeah, what is the error we are getting? Okay, so we have duplicate, I think, duplicate, you can say. So let me, what I will do, what is there? Okay, duplicate element we are getting. So date by user, okay. This is the date which is entered by the user. I will copy this, that one, and I will, I think it, here is the one. Okay, here I will provide this. Okay, so I think it will work fine. So this time let us check again. I will run the program, and this time anyone from you will tell what is the date should I enter. Anyone? 1 to 30. Sorry, 31. Okay, so I think maybe you can get one issue with that. Let us check whether 31 December and okay, and what you are saying, December 2020. So let us enter that. Okay, so it will again start execution. Again, it will come to December 2020, and okay, it will click it. So you can see that it is selected. Are you able to see? Or should I run it again? Hello? Okay, so likewise, if we try to execute again, right, for some random data. So if I, what is the date should I enter? Okay, anyone? '22 is the date, and you can see November 2021. Okay, is it the one? Sorry, what you are saying? It will fail because you will see why it will fail. Because you can see every time you have to match that exact text here, right? If I come to here it is not the short one, you can see. Yeah, so because you have to match with that text only, then only you will be able to find. So you cannot, even if you provide like that, it will fail. Okay, so let I am pressing enter after that, so it will select 22 November 2021. So let us check it, whether it is working correctly or not. Again, it will click the calendar November 2021. It will click on 22. You can see. Are you able to see? So likewise, you can see that whatever the date you provide here, okay, any date and any year, it will be able to select. So this is how you can handle the calendar UI in, you can say, in Selenium, with the help of Selenium code. So is it clear to everyone? I hope. Sorry, if the user age calendar, I am getting age calculator, not calendar. So let me open this website. If I, which one? Okay. So even if you see this, is it the one? No, it is again the same thing. Like you have to click on this. Let me open. Okay, if I go to that site only, which is this one, right? Even if I try to come here, and then if I, no, it is, I don't know what is the type of calendar you are talking. This is the one, but first of all, let me check how I got that. I think I need to click this. Okay, what happened if I click this? You can see, yeah. If I click this, and if I click this, November 2021, right? So even if you have to do like that, you will do the same thing again. Okay, just fetch that text to 2021 and keep on pressing the next button till you reach 2022, and whatever the months you have to select, you can select from here. Logic will be the same. try that. Okay, even you can try that one type of calendar here. See, here it is, here there are two calendar, but suppose if you can say that here there are two calendar, right? If I try to inspect that, here the approach will again be the same. So, but we are interested only in suppose this one, right? If so, this is highlighting whole. Okay, but we are interested in so only you can say the second one. So this is the you can say if you try to write the XPath from here, okay, we will then we can easily work on that second calendar. Okay, so try that also. Is it clear? See here also if you try to see the dates, okay, if I click here, so I think. So if I try to write the XPath till here, right? First, TD table class equals to double slash table. Okay, so you are getting two element. So what I have told you already, if you are getting two element, but this time I do not interest. I am not interested in the. Okay, let me make it first little bit big. But if I am not interested in the first element, I will just move to second element. So this is our second element. Okay, after that what I have to do, I have to come to that date. First I will go to T body. Okay, so I will write T body. Okay, I have come here. After that I will write TR of 2 because TR is the second one. So I will come to first row, and after that I think I have to come here TD. So if I select this, it will select all the date. So likewise you can see that it is selecting this. I need to write it more clear. I think TR slash, if I okay, so I think this is the one TR slash TD. If I write TR here, so you can see that it is highlighting all the red. So even also your concept will remain the same. Okay, you can collect all the dates in one, you can say list, after that fetch that data one by one, okay, and try to click that. So here also you can write one XPath or CSS, whatever you like. So is it clear to everyone? Okay, so as of now I think it is more than sufficient for today's session. Okay, in the next session, we will try to learn some other web element as well. Okay, so yeah, I will provide it after shortly. Okay, don't worry. Plus recording as well, end of the day. Okay, so yeah, I think I have uploaded already. Have you checked the? Yeah, I think I have uploaded today only. Can you check the YouTube channel on the particular playlist? I have uploaded, right? Check and let me know. I think it is related to static dropdown or dynamic dropdown, something like this. Okay, so I have uploaded already in the morning. One thing you can do, you can subscribe the channel, otherwise you will miss the video every time because you will not get notification. Okay. Okay. So you get got the video, right? You got the video now. Okay. Okay, thank you. So thank you everyone for attending today's session. We'll see you again. Okay, so Weber was saying something. Okay, Weber, you are getting some kind of. Okay, share your screen again. So rest. Sorry, Sanjeevi, what you are saying? So rest of the people can leave, right? So thank you everyone for attending the session for today, and we'll be uploading the video shortly. Okay, let me do one thing. I am not able to see your screen very clearly. Web driver. Okay, so after that web driver, what you have written, web driver dot, no, no, first line, first line, first line, system dot set property line, web driver dot. I think after that, okay, actually your screen is not visible to me. Okay, try executing it, what you are getting. Can you read out it for me? Because I'm not able to see properly the text. Okay. Starting Chrome driver. See what is the error? You can see here only. The version of Chrome driver only supports Chrome version 81. So what I am saying, what you will do first, go here, okay, go to set help about, okay, go okay, about Google Chrome, and check for that version, okay. If it try to update, then let it update. Is it updating on your end the same version as I am displaying here? Okay, after that copy that version so that you can view it later. What I will do, come here, Chrome driver, Chrome driver download. I hope you already downloaded it, right? Okay, so what you can see, I think if you see here 85.0 dot, this is the closest one, so I will suggest you to download this one. Oh yeah, do it again, do it again, maybe it will work this time, because the error itself is saying that version is not stable. This is the reason you are getting this version of Chrome driver only supports Chrome. So you have 85, right? But because I am having the same, you can say, if I, because I am having 85, that version which I have showed you recently, that is the same version I am having, right? So do one thing, that try to again, or do one thing, even if that not work, then try to download the remaining chrome.exe file, three more in on that side, and try with that, maybe that work. This is the only issue. Okay, office one. Okay, so I even it that can be a possibility, maybe you have to just ask from your manager or someone, maybe. Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Bye.